Hello, Sega kids. Welcome to our game show. I'm Augustine.
And I'm Jesse, and today we're playing Pictionary. Augustine, are you ready?
Of course I'm ready. Let's get to it.
Is it a triangle?
No. Want to give another guess, Jesse?
Can you do a little bit more? Can you give me a hint?
I got you, bro. All right, Jesse, did that help?
Is it cheese?
No, close, but let me give you one more hint.
If you guys didn't get it, it's
pizza.
Now it's my turn to draw.
Is it a square?
No.
Maze?
No, this is my last hint.
If you guys couldn't guess it, it's a TV. Hey guys, today we're gonna play Guess That Volunteer.
Today's volunteer, he's tall. He has a beard and he preaches.
Can you guess who it is? It's Ricky!
Today's guest, she's blonde, she does worship, and she has a great smile.
Can you guess who it is? It's Angelina!
She speaks Spanish, works with the next kids, and loves to dance.
Can you guess who it is? It's Primo!
She has long black hair, loves arts and crafts, and walks around with the radio.
Can you guess who it is?
It's Nairobi!
Alive. He's you fall. Come shake the ground with the sound of revival. Let heaven roar and fire fall. Come shake the ground with the sound of revival.
Jesus.
Heyo!
Who's the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus was born in Bethlehem and grew up in Nazareth, where he grew in wisdom and favor with God and man.
Oh, I see.
This is John the Baptist.
Hey!
John loved God with his whole heart.
Hey, all you!
And he told everyone that the Savior of the world was coming soon.
Wow!
Come on!
John baptized people in the Jordan River.
Woo-hoo!
And one day, Jesus went to this river to be baptized by John.
Hold on.
But John tried to talk him out of it. Jesus said, "It should be done, for we must carry out all that God requires."
Okay.
So John baptized Jesus. And as Jesus came out of the water, the heavens opened and John saw the Holy Spirit coming down as a dove and resting on Jesus. A voice from heaven said, "This is my dearly loved Son, who brings me great joy." And John knew, without any doubt, that this was the one they had all been waiting for. This was the chosen one of God, who would take away the sin of the world.
Hey guys, welcome back. This time we're gonna do a paint. We're used to a paint like just coloring. We're gonna do something different. So you're gonna need pencils, you're gonna need white paper, and you're gonna need your color pencils. For this time, you're gonna draw whatever you like. This time, I'm just gonna do a tree, a house. Just a normal day. So we're gonna start drawing whatever we like. I just did the tree, the house, the sun, and a few clouds. After you draw, how we're gonna do it? We're gonna paint different way. You can do lines, you can do circles, you can do something different how you're used to paint. So for the sun, I'm just gonna do lines. For the clouds, I'm just gonna do a little circles. Then for the tree, I'm gonna keep doing lines because that's the more easiest one. Just do it a different way. Here, just gonna do semicircles. And at the end, you should have something like this. You can do whatever shape you want, whatever direction you want. You can do lines, you can do circles, whatever you want. Just try to paint a different way that you're used to doing. That's everything for today. Bye, see you in the next one.
Hey guys, I wanted to welcome you guys to our service online. My name's Angelina and I wanted to share a quick word with you guys. So, today's topic is about hearing God's voice. Now, if you have your Bibles, open up to Isaiah 55, verse 8 through 9. Are you there? I'll give you 1 minute. 60, 59, 58, 57. I'm just kidding. Okay, so the verse is Isaiah 55, 8 through 9. And it says, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my way, declare the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts." So what do you think about that verse? Let it sink in. Because in that verse, it says that His ways are higher than ours. We will never comprehend of what He does in our lives, but His ways are always higher. What He wants is the best for us. And going into the Word and going into hearing His voice, you know, God is always hearing you. God always wants to hear petitions. God always wants to hear your prayers. But how to listen to God? And I'm gonna give you simple things, very simple things. And what I always say, you know, to the kids or to you guys is when you are talking to God, just open your heart, just be honest with Him and talk to Him about what's going on because He is always listening. Now, when it comes to listening to God's voice, sometimes we can't hear Him. And there are examples that I can give you on why. Now, are you listening to His voice? And there are things that can affect when you're not listening to His voice. Number one, are you giving attitude towards your parents? Are you disrespecting your parents? Number two, are you obeying your parents? Are you listening to them? Now, another reason can be your friendships. How are your friendships? Do you have friendships that benefit you or do you have bad friendships that you do bad decisions with? These are things that can affect you from listening to God. Now, like I said, when you want to open up to God and if you want to hear God, you have to open up your heart and you have to be vulnerable with Him. Now, God always knows what's best for you because it says His ways are higher than your ways. So always remember that whatever decision that you make, whatever prayer that you have, go to God and listen to God because His ways are always better and higher. So when you pray, just ask God to guide you and let God be the center of it all. And everything that you do, always good. Always put God first in everything. So I just want to leave you guys with that today. And remember that listen to God, pray to God, be open, be vulnerable, and let God be the center of it all. So with that being said, I'm going to close off in prayer so everyone can close their eyes and bow their head. Thank you, God, for this time. Thank you for each and every kid that is watching online. I pray that you may just be able to help us, that you may just be able to guide us, and God, that we may just be able to listen to your voice, and that we may put you in the center of it all. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a good day, guys, and see you soon. Bye.